Despite not really liking this weapon balance update all that much, I do still like Battlefield 5 overall and what it has to offer at the moment. So to try and get myself through what is going to be a pretty tough time with this new weapon balance, I've been pulling together some loadouts that I am having success with. And in this video, I'm going to pitch those to you. So if you're struggling to get to grips with what DICE has set us up with in-game right now, you've got some loadouts that you can try. And you can sort of cheat the new system a little bit and use a bugged MG42 setup for maximum cheese. This video today is sponsored by Elgato. For all your gaming and recording needs, Elgato has got you covered. Perhaps there's a creator in your life this Christmas that needs a setup boost. Look no further than Elgato. Link at the top of the description, click that for more details. Okay, what about this bugged MG42 loadout then? Discovered in the last couple of days, some players have found that DICE seemingly forgot to adjust the damage values for the MG42 when the high velocity bullet specialization is applied to it. And that means you can access the pre-update 5.2 damage values for one of the fastest firing MMGs in the game. In fact, it is the fastest firing MMG in the game. It gives you access to that 4-6 bullet to kill monster that we all knew and hated because of that guy who just sit prone or sit behind cover and would blast you off the face of the earth. Well, now you can be that guy. Although it's clearly not supposed to be that way, it has been a lot of fun killing people with it. Now obviously this is unintended behavior in the game right now. DICE didn't do this on purpose, but we can now add it to the ever-growing list of oddities that this weapon balance update introduced last week. We've got SMGs out-damaging assault rifles at certain ranges, massively buffed sniper rifles and bolt-action carbines because they weren't adjusted in the patch. That gives them much greater long-range damage potential than any other weapon category in the game. Certain weapons eclipsing others and nullifying them, which goes completely against the goals of the setup itself. And various other issues as well. I'm not going to go into detail because I spent pretty much all of my weekend making this video, which explains all the issues DICE created and offers examples to those issues as well. So if you missed that video, go and check it out. With this MG42 though, just because it does have those now outdated damage values within a certain setup, that doesn't actually mean that you're going to dominate everyone 24/7. It is still an MMG at the end of the day, and that means within Battlefield 5, no aiming down sights unless you deploy your bipod. And in the case of the MG42 as well, you get some serious initial recoil when you start firing this thing. In sustained fire, if you can control the recoil, you are still more likely at range to just deliver suppression points rather than kill anybody. There is no high-powered scope options with the MMGs in this game, and even if there were, the likelihood of you being able to keep those bullets hitting the target at range is extremely low. It's still a gun that's going to pepper a target at range rather than killing them. It's when that action comes a little bit closer to home that you're going to notice just how good this thing is. Into the mid-range, and especially at the moment in the close-range combat situations, you can absolutely destroy people with this thing. And because all other weapons are now a little bit worse than what they were before, it highlights just how severe of a rebalance DICE implemented to the weapons in this game. When you are using a weapon with the old statistics versus a slew of weapons using the new statistics. If you want to get a taste of just how good this thing can be right now, you best go and do it ASAP before DICE patches it out of the game. I know it's on their radar already, and it has likely been fixed internally for the next update to Battlefield 5, but right now, if you want to have a bit of a cheese fest, then this is a weapon that you should go and use. But the MG42 is kind of one of the outliers. It's clearly broken and it's not working the way that it's supposed to in that setup. If you want to stay a little bit more legitimate, perhaps, I do have a few other weapon setups that you can use across the different classes. So I'll go through some of those now. For the assault class, you still can't really go wrong with the STG-44. It's a weapon that can still adapt to most gunfight situations. With it being a 5-8 bullet to kill gun, you're only firing one more bullet at close range than you were before the update, which to me, really isn't that big of a deal. In the mid-range combat scenarios, the recoil decrease that it's had alongside those range damage reductions, it makes it really easy to land shots on target now. So if you're engaging with other assault players or support players, you are definitely going to be competitive in mid-range gunfights. And if you're up against a medic that's running an SMG, you are very much likely to kill them. And then at long range, you can of course switch over to semi-automatic fire with the STG, which is something that I've been doing since the game released, so that's nothing new for me. Semi-automatic fire removes a huge amount of the stacking recoil, where the next shot is fired before the recoil has fully reset. So if you leave enough of a gap between each shot fired, you are going to be landing shots fairly easily because this weapon has received a recoil reduction in update 5.2. The range damage reduction does kick in a little bit, so you will still need more bullets to kill than before the patch, but if you've got good aim, then you should at the very least be able to let the enemy know that you are trying to kill them. For the medic class, I have two different options at the moment that I'm finding really effective. One of them is really quite obvious, and the other one might not be so obvious, so I'll start with that one. This is an SMG-based loadout. I'm running the Type 100 with specializations that focus on improving the accuracy of it. The Type 100 is one of those new balanced middle-of-the-road SMGs now, so it's not geared towards long-range combat, and it's not a 100% hip-fire machine either, like the Suomi or the Thompson. But you can use it in both of those situations, and you can still be quite successful with it. I've paired it with a Model 27 revolver, and that amps up the amount of damage that my soldier can output in this scenario, and it makes for a really nice finishing weapon if you run out of ammunition, and it outputs a lot more damage per shot than the Type 100 ever can, so if you wanted to try a lucky shot at longer range, you might still be able to pull off a pretty impressive kill. And then, if you want a proper ranged medic loadout, then just look no further than the Jungle Carbine. Untouched by the 5.2 update, it is still just as good as it was before, and it performs exactly the same as I said here in this video. It's got a really long one-hit kill headshot distance out to roughly 100 meters, and it's got a fast rate of fire as well, and that means follow-up shots will be easier to land. Add to that a 10-round internal magazine, and you've got yourself a really deadly weapon to use as a medic if you do want to reach out a little bit further. And then, for the support class, besides this bugged MG42 that makes me laugh every single time I use it, there's the Massen MG. Because of its fairly slow rate of fire compared to other weapons, and the fact that the magazine sticks right up into your vision, DICE decided to give it a flat 6-bullet-to-kill damage model. This means at any range, it will only ever take 6 bullets to kill an enemy if you're landing body shots. So it's an extremely predictable weapon to use, and it makes it one of the most consistent in the game right now. Your enemy could be 5 or 500 meters away from you, and it'd still only take 6 bullets to kill them. Nice. At close range, you will be beaten out by 4-bullet-to-kill close-range SMGs, but then at nearly every other range, you are a competitive player on the battlefield. This thing is really, really good right now. And then, for the recon class, nothing has changed here, so run with whatever you like, because pretty much all the damage values have stayed the same. Play recon the same way you did before the patch, and you're probably going to profit quite heavily. The more I play with update 5.2, the more I find myself avoiding the clear issues that the balance brings, and I find myself picking these new best case weapons, which was supposed to be one of the things that DICE eliminated with this patch. Previous top pick weapons were supposed to be brought in line with all of the other weapons in the game to make every single weapon viable, but at the same time, DICE clearly adjusted other weapons and made them better above the rest, so we're still in a similar situation to where we were before the patch, just with a slightly different set of weapons becoming more popular and other weapons falling by the wayside. I expect DICE will try and address that in whatever patch is coming next, but at the moment, it doesn't appear that they fixed their weapon balance problem really at all. So, there you go then, some different loadouts that you can try and use to push your way through update 5.2 and have some fun with Battlefield 5. A big thanks for watching today. Maybe drop some of your new loadouts down below that you're enjoying in the comments section and share them with the community. At the moment, we're all looking for some good loadouts to use, so why not share the ones that you've had some success with? But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.